there's another, I gotta have to do this again, sorry. Ugh, no. There's another story, actually, that was really just so, speaks so much to who Henry's nature, you know, kindness and compassion, that's the word I was looking for. And there was this, you know, this wonderful foundation, Make-A-Wish Foundation, and there was a little boy, who a young boy who had cancer, and his wish was to meet Fonzie. And the our ritual on Fridays is that we would tape the show, and then everybody would get out of hair and makeup and go and have a long dinner break, and then we'd go back and tape the second show. And so we would have dinner together in the commissary, and people would be, you know, in their civilian clothes. So this was the day this young man was there, and he was there with his parents and his siblings, and he, I'm not going to be able to tell this without puddling up. So he had, maybe he had been to the, to see the first tape show, and then he was invited into the commissary, you know, to be with us. And Henry comes in, and Henry's not out of his hairdo and his leather jacket, and, you know, we've all been told about this young boy's terrible plight. And so Henry came in, not as Henry, as Fonzie, because he knew that that boy did not want to meet Henry. He wanted to meet Fonzie. So, oh, dearie me. So, and Fonzie was able to say things to this child that Henry could never have said, you know. I mean, I can't think of any of the phrases now, but lovely sort of slang phrases to encourage him to hang in there and fight the good fight and hang tough and all this stuff. So, and then later I learned that it was Henry who, as Make-A-Wish Foundation supports the child and a parent to come out. Well, Henry flew the rest of the family out, put them up in a beautiful hotel over the weekend, made sure they had lots of tours and extra things to do that the foundation just couldn't have supported. Henry did all of that, and those were, he did many of those small anonymous kindnesses. Yeah. Okay, now I am crying. Sorry.